Join us for a quick look at a kind of gimmicky party game from The Op, Tapple. Thanks to The Op for letting us take a review copy of this one home from Origins. Moe's wanted a copy of this one for a long time.
So there's more history to this game than I ever realized. So the game we know of as Tapple got its start in the form of Pim Pam Pet, which is a Dutch game where the players get a parameter card and then spin this spinner, and there's a gap in the spinner that would show a letter. You then had to say a word that started with the letter that matched your parameter, and then you would spin again and you try to see how many you could do in a row. Well, a number of different versions of Pim Pam Pet were released, including card versions and dice versions and so on. There's a whole bunch of these. Eventually, they put out one called Pip Pam Pet the Battle, which was pretty much the game we know today as Tapple. Now, so the Tapple name comes from USAopoly, who brought the game to North America in 2013 in the form of what is now considered Tapple English First Edition. Now, similar to the game it's based on, Tapple then spread itself around the world, spanning various editions. The French and Swedish versions happen to be called Last Letter Standing. Over in the UK, it's called Think Words. Well, the version we actually have in our hands, which you can see behind me here, is the latest English version, which was just re-released and updated in 2021, generally called the English Edition 2021.
Now, while each of these versions changed up things like the card contents and the color of the letter disc, the basic gameplay has remained the same since 2013.
Now, this latest edition of Tapple is listed as playing 2 to 10 players, age 8 and up, with a playtime of 30 minutes. While there's theoretically no reason you couldn't play more with 10, like I'm not quite sure where they pulled that number out of, it does get hard to cram everyone around the table around the little Tapple wheel so they can reach it to play. And yes, you can pass it, but once you get to a large group, that becomes more difficult.
The Tapple is a mass market game, so you can find it at pretty much any large department store, toy store, as well as hobby game stores, and most online shops. It has an MSRP of $21.99 US.
Now, Tapple is basically a mashup of traditional word games type you probably grew up playing and played in English class and stuff like that, and hot potato. You get a category, then you have 10 seconds to come up with a word that matches that category. Then it goes to the next player who has to come up with a different word with a different first letter. And what happens in this that makes it more of a game and where the Tapple wheel comes in is that it tracks what letters have been used and has a built-in timer. That's all tracked on the wheel.
For a look at this wheel and some of the category cards that come in the latest edition of this word-based game, check out our Tapple unboxing video on YouTube. It's worth a watch just to see how Moe's memory of the game didn't quite match the reality of it.
It was close. I swear, somewhere, I played a mechanical version of Tapple that, like, mechanically clicked. I swear that exists. I had a total Mandela effect going on here for me on this one. Now, a couple of things that are important to know here that I learned during the unboxing. For one, this game, batteries are not included. This is a battery-powered board game. You don't get batteries. Two, once you get the game open, the plastic word wheel has a slot underneath that holds all the cards. So everything you need is held in the gimmicky toy thing, which is pretty cool. So there's actually no reason to keep the box here, unless you're someone who's a collector and needs the box on your Kallax. You just keep the wheel.
Now, Tapple is a dead simple game to learn. You start by taking the category cards out of the bottom of the wheel. You turn it on and flip it over. If any letters are pushed down, reset the wheel by pinching the letter release lever,
which for some reason there are 5 of, so you can pick any one of those. I still find a little odd. Now, the start player, technically the player whose middle initial is closest to A, takes the top card from the deck and picks one of the 4 categories on it to be the clue for that round.
These are actually color-coded based on difficulty, with one side of the card better suited for younger players.
Now, the current player announces the category aloud, taps the timer in the middle of the wheel. They then have 10 seconds to name something that matches the category that starts with an available letter on the Tapple wheel. Once they have it, they say it, they push down the matching letter and tap the timer.
Now it's the next player's turn to come up with a different word using a different letter, hitting the letter and then the timer when they have one.
Timer runs out, you're eliminated for the round. Next player in player order taps the timer and continues playing until one person's left.
The last player standing wins the round and takes the category card. Then, a new round is started and played the same way. The game ends when a single player has collected three category cards.
It's the basics. Like most simple games, there are a couple little additional rules in there for outliers and situations that may come up. This includes the fact that a player is eliminated if they say a word that doesn't match the category, which if it's up for vote, you put it up for vote. If players don't agree, the majority decides if you're here or not. Or if you hit the wrong letter, this one's important. This has come up in many games I've played where people say one thing and then miss or hit the wrong thing. You are eliminated for hitting the wrong letter.
Saying xylophone and hitting Z is going to get you in trouble.
Yes.
And then there's overtime. If all the letters get pressed during a round, a new round is started with the remaining players. A new category is drawn, and each player has to say two answers on their turn instead of one.
If those players somehow get through it again, you do it again. But this time, you're going to have to name three things. And now, you'll have three category cards in play. So in both of the overtime forms, the person who wins actually gets to take both of those. So technically, if you win a game in double overtime, you just won that entire game at Tapple.
Well, there you go. You now know how to play Tapple.
Go forth and spread the Tapple joy to others. Now, I'm sure there's some people sitting here going, why are you talking about Tapple? Like, this is a pretty popular mass market game that most people have at least heard of or seen on the store shelves. Well, the thing is, it's a really solid high player count game that is great for catching people's attention. Now, I first played Tapple many years ago at our first ever Windsor Extra Life event, way too early in the morning. And I have been meaning to pick up a copy ever since. I just never got around to it. So when we were at Origins and we're meeting with the op and we're hanging out and they are showing off this awesome new game called The Art Project. Look forward to that. It looks really cool. I noticed they had Tapple on the shelf behind them. And I asked if it would be cool with us grabbing a review copy, and they said yes.
So, did the game live up to your memory of it?
Yeah, pretty much, except for the fact I remember it being mechanical and not electronic. The gameplay was exactly what I remembered. Now, when we did play the first time, if I remember, we left the category cards in the box, and we were just making up our own stuff based on whatever, Doctor Who actors or something. But most importantly, what the game did is exactly what it did at 3 a.m. on Saturday night during Extra Life. It had that effect. It brought people out of their shells. It got people talking. It got people playing games. I brought this out to a barbershop bar event, and it was everything I wanted it to be. That is the reason I'm talking about Tapple. I am mainly talking about Tapple for those of you looking for games to bring to public play events. This is the kind of game that catches people's attention. It gets people wondering what's going on. First off, the toy. Like, look at that thing. You see that thing and you're like, what the heck is this? And you want to touch it. Every time I brought this out to a game event and put it with the pile of games, it is the most picked up thing. Whether people go back to a table with it or play is a different thing, but they at least look at it. Like, the thing looks like a letter frisbee and possibly a deadly weapon. Second, as a typical electronic toy, it's loud. You can't help but hear the ticking and especially the buzzer when it goes off. Third, the people who are playing it tend to be even louder than the game. People are screaming out words. They're cursing when they can't think of a word. They cheer when a player gets a word at the last second. The players who are eliminated tend to pick favorites out of who's left and cheer for people. There's booing. There's umming and aahing. It's great. This can turn into quite the rowdy party game that draws a crowd.
Amusingly, aside from Mo mentioning it fondly from time to time on this show, I had never heard of Tapple. Now, likely I had seen it probably on the shelves at stores from time to time, but it certainly never registered on my mind in any way.
So this is the kind of game that catches people's attention, has them looking over and coming over to see what the fuss is. And one of the great things about this, how quick a round is that person can be just tossed into the game for the next round so easily. This is a great opportunity to invite people to get involved and play at public gaming events. One of the things I love about public play events is I tend to have them in a place where there's gamers and non-gamers, and it's the way to get those non-gamers to become gamers. That's why I've wanted my own copy of Tapple for years, and I am so happy I have a copy now.
Really is perfectly suited to those public play hosted events. Well, assuming that the volume and language aren't a problem. It might be an issue at a quieter location or one where dropping an F-bomb as the timer goes off on you is frowned upon.
There is something else. We've talked about Session Zero for board games before. Depending on who you're playing with, you might want to have a conversation about what kind of words will be allowed. Now, all that said, right? I got what I wanted. I like that part's definitely positive. Tapple did exactly what I wanted it to do. It's a great game for bringing out to public play events, but it surprised me. What surprised me is how much my own family has enjoyed playing this kind of silly gimmicky party game, this very toyetic thing. Now I got it for public play, but my kids love playing this game. They must have played 7, 8, maybe 12 rounds in a row the first time I brought it out with them. Now, yes, they had fun playing with the family and everyone playing, but then they took it up to the room and did the two-player thing where they were trying to challenge each other with categories and coming up with stuff they're into, right? These are a couple teen girls who are going involved playing Tapple to come up with who knew more magic spells or who knew more Pokemon or who knew all the more warrior cats. To tie in with the episode theme of tonight, this was a great game for my teens.
So once I understood what the game was, I realized it's quite similar to an old campfire game I knew. The difference being, since you couldn't really have the device at a campfire, you just use the last letter of the previous guess as your required first letter. And that was how you prevented word reuse.
Yeah, basically that's what it is. It's that hot potato with a nice toy for tracking things. So, well, I wanted a game to entertain big groups of public play events and hopefully draw some new people in. I got that. I also ended up with a quick-to-learn, easy-to-understand, fast-playing party game that my own family greatly enjoys.
Winning all around, it turns out, just goes to show that not everything that's mass market is necessarily a bad game. It's more about finding the right times and places for such games, assuming they really are games, but that's not a problem here.
Now, that's a lot of praise, right? But Tapple is obviously not for everyone. The biggest problem with this game is it can be anxiety inducing. This is a real time game where you have to think on your feet. This is the kind of game that stresses people out. If you have anxiety issues, you probably are not going to enjoy Tapple. It's not going to be a game for you. Heck, the timer ticking away with your mind goes completely blank, just trying to think of something like crayon colors can get to me. So I fully understand that it's not going to be for some players.
If you're the kind of person who freezes at getting anything else done while you're waiting for the microwave or blanks out when people turn to you for an answer in a meeting, this might not be for you.
Now, if you don't mind the stress of real-time games and like high player count party games, I don't think you'll go wrong with Tapple. Just make sure you pick up some batteries at the same time you grab the game.
And do mind your language around the kids.
Now, if you don't dig real-time games or don't like party games or hate being put on the spot or don't like word games, there's lots of reasons here to dislike Tapple. You probably aren't listening right now, but yeah, it's not going to be for you.
It's really that simple. It's a fun real-time world game. If that's your thing, grab it. If that's not your thing, move along.
Personally, I'm super happy I got a copy. I've wanted it forever. And while it didn't quite work the way it did in my memory, I'm still going to keep searching for the mechanical version of Tapple. Maybe I saw a prototype. I don't know. But it perfectly fit the niche I intended it to fit and then ended up being better than expected for my own group and family. So bonus.
Well, that's it for our review of Tapple, a real-time mass market party game that we think is great for big group game nights and public play. Mm-hmm. We're always looking for new games to bring out to our local events. What's a game you would recommend that's great at catching people's attention and potentially hooking a new player? Let us know in the comments.
Now, I also invite you to check out my written review of Tapple when it goes live over on the blog. For those of you catching the audio version of this review, it should be there now over at tabletopbellhop.com. Finally, if you'd enjoyed this review and the other content we produce, please consider tipping the Bellhop by heading to patreon.com/tabletopbellhop.